will be out. Maybe we will recover Vincent Janssen, be available for to be selected. And then it's, I think, all okay.
Toby, okay.
Toby is training well, and I think it will be good.
You had a lot of players signing new contracts recently, even Michel Ball today, but the big one yesterday, Hugo Lloris. What message do you think that sent to have him signed up?
Well, I think it's fantastic for the club. It's a very good thing. All our players want to be involved in the project for a long term. That I think is a fantastic news for us. I think it's a very, very, very good signal, very good message for our people, for the club. I think the player showing the commitment with the club is because they believe in that project, and I think that make us very, very proud of that.
Is there a feeling of relief that he signed as well? Has he been linked with other clubs before? Were you ever close to losing him in the past?
No, I think no. Always Hugo, in 2 years and a half, he showed to me the commitment and never feel that about to lose him. But we know very well him, and he's one of the best keepers on the world, and always can arrive the temptation for the another club or for him. But I think always was. I think nothing changed because the feeling was always Hugo want to show his commitment with the club, and now was a great opportunity, no? Because extend the contract and to be honest with us, with the club, and really believe in that project, I think it's very good for us.
Any news on Lamela and Alderweireld with regard to any improvement on their terms on their contract?
Rumours, but you know. Maybe we finish with a few players more and then we start the cycle again. Maybe I extend the contract again.
Is Southampton next?
Yes.
Is it still an emotional fixture for you, going back there?
Yeah, it's always be special to come back to Southampton. Yes, it was a very special, and is a very special place for me, for my family. And to have the possibility to start my career in England, in the Premier League, I think it will be always a special place for me. And a lot of people that we have still the relationship and people that love them, always be special for me. A good opportunity to see all the friends there.
Puel is now in charge there. What have you made of the job that he's done there so far?
No, I think he's done a fantastic job. I know very well him from France. I think he's a great coach, and he's doing a fantastic job. I think they are playing very well, and with a good result, I think he's doing a very, very, very good job.
You've won 2 games in a row. But there's been 3 games that Harry Kane hasn't scored. Is that a concern to you at all? Are you worried?
No, I am not worried about him. Always repeat the same, because I feel the same. For me, he's one of the best strikers in the world. And for different reason, maybe he didn't score in the last few games. But I am sure and no doubt that it's only a few games, and he's a fantastic player, he's a top scorer, and no doubt that he will start to score as soon as possible.
You're just 1 point off the top four at the moment.
Yes.
10 points off Chelsea. Is the title still a realistic possibility?
If you have time to see a little bit the table, then last season, I think was the same. 7-8 points with Leicester. I think it's realistic. It's realistic because the gap is 10 points, but it's realistic because a lot of game to play. Another thing is if we can achieve that and we can fight for the title on the end of the season. That is up to us. Believe and be ambitious and try to give our best to try to improve every week, every game. But of course that today is realistic. Today is 17 games. It's more than half season ahead. All is possible in football.
Harry Kane alluded to it a couple of weeks ago, that this period, this time last year, is when Spurs really kicked on. In the 9 games from Boxing Day, you took something like 22 points out of 27. Does that give you confidence going into this period now?
We are confident. We are working very hard. I arrived late now because more than 2 hours and a half was the training session, and it's for that I arrived late here. Sorry for that. And yes, and then we'll see what happened. But we are very focused in trying to win points. That is a period, very important period. It's true that it's not decisive period, but it's important to cross that period in a very good position and to attack the last 3-4 months on the Premier League with the possibility to try to fight for the top four.
Now, some of the teams around you are losing some key players to the Africa Cup of Nations. You don't have that problem this time. Is that an advantage to you? Is that positive news for you?
I think it's positive because we don't have any player involved in that situation, and I think it will be positive for us.
Just on January, I know you'll be asked this a lot of times when
yes.
The window actually opens. Do you expect to be busy? How many do you expect to bring in?
Maybe on the last day, maybe. But no, I think it's like before. No, it's too difficult to improve your squad on January. I think for all the clubs, and I don't expect too much movement.
Just finally, Maurizio, we've seen today that Chelsea and Shanghai have agreed terms on Oscar going to China for what's believed to be £60 million. He's only 25 years old. Sometimes when players move to these leagues, they're coming towards the end of their careers, but he seems to be at his peak. Is this a worry? Is this a bit of a game changer with regard to China? And is it a danger to the Premier League, do you think?
No, I don't believe that will be danger for us. I think I can accept all the decision, but like you say, it's sometimes it's difficult to understand that decision, this type of decision. No, for me, football is not only money. Sorry.
In what way is it difficult for you to understand?
No, because for me, football is not only money. I think it's to be competitive, compete in a. For me, Premier League is the most important league in the world. And for me, enjoy football and to compete. That is not my job because it's only money. It's because it's my passion. I need to feel the passion and I need to feel the competition, no? To compete with the best on the world. And when you are in the Premier League, like a manager, you are competing with the best manager, you are competing with the best teams, the best player, and that is for it means a lot more than money.
The reason I ask is it a danger is because say they came in for some of your players, bandying about these big sums of money, sometimes it would be hard to resist. What would you say?
But do you know, I think my players today, my feeling is they like to play football and they like to compete with the best player on the world, and Premier League is the case, no? To be competitive. And I think, yes, for me, it would be strange if some player our player decide to move in that direction. But you know, different player, different circumstance, different situation. I respect all the decision and all the opinion.
Thank you. This is definitely my final question.
Okay.
Alan Pardew left his job at Crystal Palace.
Yes.
Sam Allardyce is favourite to come back in. What did you make of the decision to leave Alan Pardew, relieve him of his job? Did it come as a surprise to you?
Today, no. Today in football, any decision surprised me. But I don't know what, or I didn't know what was happening on Crystal Palace. Only, it's a sad news because it's your colleague, and always is difficult. But I cannot give a real opinion about that situation because I wasn't involved, and then I don't know all that was happened in the last few months in there, no?
Just now,
okay. Okay. Good. You are funny today.
must be Christmas.
Yes. Yeah. Good welcome, eh? Yeah. To the...
Tom.
Hugo Lloris's contract. This contract expires. I think he'll be 35. Do you think he can maybe finish his career here at Tottenham?
That is a question for him. I think for a keeper, you have a lot of example that if you keep your body fit, you can play. It's different to another position on the pitch. I think I think it's a question for him. I don't know. We are very happy. I think it's to start to talk about his end or his to talk about the how he finished his career. I think it's too far about that. He's only 29 year old. Is for a keeper is very young. Still is very young.
Because we had here Brad Friedel, I think played until he was 40.
40, yes, it was 40, 41, no?
42,
or 42, yes, yes.
Did Hugo is fit enough that he could maybe?
He's fit enough, yes. It's like Brad. Yes, it's a exceptional body. If he keep fit, he can play, and he only can decide when he stop to play.
Can I ask you about Jay Rodriguez at Southampton? Because he was out for so long with his injury.
Yes.
Came back last weekend, scored 2 goals.
Very happy. I sent the text. I was very happy to see him again, to enjoy in on the pitch. He suffered, he got a very bad injury. And we remember, and we have very fresh in our mind that day on Manchester City on Etihad, and he's a top player, top man, and it's we were very happy that to see him enjoy again and score how he scored against Bournemouth.
But now back in form, just kind of the wrong time.
Yes, now we will suffer him, no, because this will be our enemy and our opponent. But you know, I am very happy that he's back and recovered his level. And because I repeat, he's not only a top player, he's a top person too.
Mark, would you ever think about reuniting with him? When you came here, there was a lot of talk about possibly him coming.
Yes, a lot of rumor. I remember that a lot of player link with Tottenham. A lot of Southampton player in that moment. Yes, Dembele is okay. Was training very good, and yes, at the moment it's only Lamela. Janssen will be good. We hope that will be good, and Toby okay. And I think it's only Lamela will be not available for Southampton.
Lovely. Okay. You're welcome. Alistair, you want one? Just go on, last one.
That's all right. The new deals for Lloris and Vaughan, does that have any kind of bearing on whether you try to make Paulo Lopez's move permanent?
No, it's nothing to do with Pau. I think it's the three keepers are in different situation, different position, different level. I think it's Pau is more a present and future. I think nothing to do with Pau.
Thank you.
Yes, nothing related.
Extra couple of days you guys are going to have over some of the other teams. Is that going to benefit you in terms of you almost have a mini winter break for these?
Sorry?
The extra couple of days off that Tottenham are getting over other teams, does it kind of give you a mini winter break almost? Is that going to benefit you in any way?
But do you know, I'm not sure we play 28, but some team play 26 and play one day before than us. We play Sunday in Barley, but you know, I think we are all in the same position, same situation. We'll play again Chelsea on one day less in between, and I think we are all in the same position on then.
Lovely. Have the cameras off.